Hi viewers, I welcome every one of you to this video. Hope you would have watched completely, fully my previous metallurgy videos. About 11 videos I uploaded, including NEET and JEE MCQ question answers with explanation. Now we'll see about P block elements. This is actually periodic table. This whole thing is periodic table. In that it is S block element. These belongs to transition elements or D block elements. These two are actinides and lanthanides and actinides belongs to F block elements. And here 13 to 18 groups, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and 18. These six groups belongs to P block elements. How do we classify these as P block elements? That will be our question. In this, even if the only one electron or only one single electron enters into the particular orbit, though we classify those elements coming under that category, S block elements, D block elements, P block elements or F block elements. Understood? Even if the single last electron enters into the particular orbit or subshell, that belongs to that block element. Understood? Then maximum number of electron in P subshell will be 6. That is Px 2 electrons, Py 2 electrons, Pz will have 2 electrons. Total number of electrons in P subshell will be, maximum number of electrons in P subshell will be 6. Then group 13 to group 18 belongs to P block elements. It consists of all type of elements such that metals, metalloids and non-metals. We can see here alkali metals are in same color. They are whatever we take, those elements are in same color, means same group. But here in P block elements, it has dark green, then fluorescent green and some sort of blue colors. That means this dark green will be metals and fluorescent green will be metalloids and other blue shades are non-metals. Understood? Here in this blue green, blue shade is metals. Here middle, these are non-metalloids and other rest of that purple color will be non-metals. In this metal, properties of metals, you would have we would have read in the lower section, such that malleability, ductility and sonority and conducts electricity, heat, everything. You are the properties of metals. That is malleability in the sense can make into thin sheets, ductility can make into thin wires, sonority make clink sound. Special property of a unique character of a metal making noise, so that in temples we use bells to make the puja time, offering puja time. Then the non-metals will not have the properties of conducting electricity, sonority, ductility and electricity. Here these metalloids in the sense which shows properties of both metals and non-metals, it is the between these two metals and non-metals, the properties of metalloids are between these two metals and non-metals, so those are called as metalloids. Understood? Then we see about boron family. Boron family is, first member of the element is boron, second member of the element is aluminium, formula as a symbol is Al, third member of boron family is gallium Ga, fourth member is indium In, fifth member thallium Tl. Then we can have a doubt how to remember the, is it necessary to remember in that same order and how to remember, any gimmicks are available, isn't it? So we can compare with our day to day's life. If you compare this with your family, and I assume if it is a single child family, and you can compare that single child will be you. Okay, assume you, and this will be in ascending order, your mother, your father, then grandmother, grandfather. Otherwise, according to your family members, siblings, that is elder brother, younger brother, whoever that is. Okay. So if I compared, I assume that the single child family. So I compared this boron is as U. Then it is a non-metal. It is in different color. It is non-metal. The other rest are in same color. Those are all metals. Okay. Then aluminium to your mother. I compared aluminium to your mother. That aluminium will be having the that is metal. My aluminium is metal. Metal will be having lustrous property, lustrous appearance. Then so it can make into malleable and ductility, can make into thin sheets and wires. That means ladies will be having flexible to the family members. One may be having the hot chocolate, one may be prefer cold chocolate, whatever that is. The that ladies, that is mother, is flexible to everyone in the family members. So aluminium to your mother, okay, isn't it? Then gallium to your father. Feature, special feature of gallium is smart metal. That means it plays vital role in LAN. LAN stands for abbreviation of this local area network. Local area network is nowadays so much essential as we are using smartphone, calculator, high speed internet connections. So it plays a, LAN plays a vital role. Gallium plays vital role in LAN as it is a compared to a smart metal. Your father, the father of a house should will be leading a family. He should have a smartness to handle the situations. Okay. So gallium compared to your smart father. Gallium is a smart metal compared to your smart father. Then indium. Indium to grandma. Ascending order we are doing. Indium to grandma. That is, as aluminium having, ladies will be having same quality. Okay, here if it is in different property, we cannot say that. As it is everything metal, we can say as the mother, grandma is eldest lady in the house, will be having same characters as mother, as a silvery white metal resembling tin. Tin is another name of a element. Okay. Then obtained a trace amount in the earth crust. It cannot have much in the earth crust. 0.21% only available. PPM in the sense parts per million. If we get million amount, if we cleaning up million kilograms, we get only 0.21%. Okay. So then at the last but not least, hero of the house is the grandfather. Thallium compared to grandfather. These will be available in trace amounts. Trace amounts in the sense, for this property, we can assume that the elders will not have much active participation in the family. Occasionally, on the occasions only, they can give their presence. Okay. In that same way, these are all trace elements and but plays a vital role in the in our day-to-day activity, isn't it? Okay, in this way, if we compare the elements, we never forget the points and chemistry will be easier to everyone, isn't it? Then electronic configuration of p block elements. General electronic configuration of p block element is ns2 np 126. ns2 in the sense, that is generally number, n represents the number of period. Okay, this 126 will be representing the which place element, that is in the p in the second period, third element, second period, fourth element. If that's such in that way, that is, it belongs to period. N represents a period, and this uppercase place is represents the place of the element. Okay, we'll see about that. Here, general electronic configuration of p block elements, eco sequence, that is boron group or 13th group elements will be ns2np1, that is outermost electron shell will have 3 electrons, 2 plus 1, 3 electrons. By accepting 2 octant octet rule, it should donate 3 electrons to the other element, and attaining by donating, it will be exhibiting plus 3 oxidation state. Or it should accept 5 electrons to attain octet rule. Accepting 5 electrons is practically impossible. So donating 3 electrons is possible. So it exhibits in plus 3 oxidation state. It is actually theoretical value, but observed is plus 1 oxidation state. Why is it so? Because after the third element, gallium, germanium, in that sense, arsenic, after this second, that means introduction of d orbital or f orbital, these two electrons, ns2 electrons, will not be taking part in the reaction. Only this one electron, two electron, three electron will take part in the reaction. So it exhibits, by donating this one electron, it exhibits plus 1 oxidation state. Understood what I said? Then in that same way, here also, it exhibits in carbon tetragen family, it outermost orbit contains 4 electrons. So by donating this 4 electron, it can exhibit plus 4 oxidation state, or accepting 4 electron, it can exhibit minus 4 oxidation state. Or if it is inactive and only these 2 electrons, it donates these 2 electrons and exhibit plus 2 oxidation state. Understood? Nictogen nitrogen family, group 15 family. Here it is having 5 electrons in the outermost orbit. That means donating all 5 electrons is not impossible practically, isn't it? So it will be accepting 3 electrons and exist minus 3 oxidation state. Otherwise, if it is, these 2 electrons become inactive, that is called inert pair effect. We will see that these 2 electrons will, because of the shielding, it will not be taking part, become inactive. So it will be donating these 3 electrons and exhibit plus 3 oxidation state. And in the same way, chalcogen, this is carbon family, it has 6 electrons in the outermost orbit. So by accepting 2 electrons, when the outermost electron is 6, it is by accepting 2 electrons, that is minus 2 oxidation state, is quite possible, isn't it? Or if it is inactive, it will be donating this 4 electrons of outermost electron. That is also possible way, plus 4 oxidation state. Otherwise, by donating these 2 electrons from this outermost electron, also possible plus 2 oxidation state. Halogen, it is 7 electrons will be outermost electron, valence shell, outermost shell in the sense, that is valence shell. So it will be, we may be saying so many theories, but it is readily accepting 1 electron, minus 1 electronic configuration, readily accepts 1 electron and attain octet rule. This is inert gases, already it has 8 electrons, so it will be inactive. Then how can we say the number of electrons, that is atomic number of an element? As identity card is important to us, the elements atomic number is most important, plays a vital role in chemistry, because based on that atomic number, it shows the electronic configuration. Based on the electronic configuration, the characters will be fixed upon the element. Okay, so how to remember the atomic number of an element? For basic numbers, we should remember either the last one or the first one, and it is the quite easy, simplest formula: plus 8 plus 8 plus 18 plus 18 plus 32 and plus 32. This is the formula we should remember: plus 8 plus 8 plus 18 plus 18 plus 32 and plus 32. This is the formula we should remember, isn't it? Okay, is it easier? Then, if it is, we may be knowing helium atomic number is 2. With that, if we add 8 electrons, neon, we get 2 plus 8, neon atomic number is 10. Then, with that, if we add 8, argon atomic number is 18. With that, next formula is 18 plus 18. 18 plus 18, krypton atomic number 36. With that, again one more time, addition of 18. So, that is 54. Xenon atomic number 54. Then, radon, with that 32. Addition of 32, we get 86. Then, again one more time, 32, that is 118 atomic number of this radioactive element. In that same way, for boron, it is atomic number of boron is 5. With 8, it is 13 for aluminium. With 18 for gallium, 31. Again, one more time, 18. Okay, 31 plus 18, 49 to indium. And one more time, 32. 32 with this 49. 81 is thallium. And again, 32. Addition of 32. Nephridium, it is 113 of radioactive element. Okay, this is the way we should remember the atomic number, that is identification of an element. Is atomic number is the identification of an element. Okay, then we'll be seeing how to write the electronic configuration of elements. Boron family, for boron family it is 2s2 2p1. In the sense, it is the second group element. First is the hydrogen, then second lithium, we in the alkali metals. It is opposite to this, in this side 13th group element. No, it is. So here, this is also parallel to this lithium. So we can say this parallel to that is the second group element. Second group element, so it is, this belongs to this. The general formula, we said NS2 NP1. This 2 belongs to period, number of period. Boron belongs to second period, first element. And aluminium belongs to third period, the first element. Gallium belongs to fourth period, first element. Indium belongs to fifth period, first element. That thallium belongs to sixth group, sixth period, first element. In that same way, sulfur belongs to third period, fourth element. Bromine belongs to fourth period, fifth element. Okay, this one, radon belongs to sixth period, sixth element. In that way, it should be written. It should be, we can able to read from the electronic configuration, we can be able to understand which element it is, which period and which place it occupies in the periodic table. Then, oxidation state and inert pair effect. We said these two electrons will not be taking part in the reaction, because when the nucleus, down the group, okay, boron to thallium down the group, number of atomic orbit will be increased. So when the number of atomic orbit increased, then distance between nucleus and the outermost shell will be increased. That is, nucleus is in positive charge and the electron is in negative charge. That is, how the electrons, how the element is able to hold, in the sense, because of the attractive force between nucleus and the electron only, positive and negative charge only, the element able to stable. Okay, otherwise it will be collapsed easily. But while the distance become more, when the introduction of orbital, number of orbital is increased, nucleus force over the last orbital and last orbit will be less, quite naturally. So in that case, that is called shielding effect, that is called a poor shielding effect. Because of the poor shielding effect, after the d orbital introduction of d orbital and f orbital, it starts. Okay, after the introduction of d orbital, this shielding efforts starts. So the control over the nucleus, the attractive force of nucleus force will over the last electron will be less. Due to that, it will be these two electrons. Previous, if it is ns2 np1, these two electrons will not take part in the reaction. Only the last electron, p orbital electron, will take part in the reaction. Okay, these two electrons, these two, these will have no problem. Actually, after this, gallium will have the problem. This 4s2 will not take part. 5s2, this 6s2 will not take part. So it will be showing +1 oxidation state. Okay, understood. So down the group, the 13th, 14th, 15th group oxidation state, it decreases down the group. Okay, because of the inert pair effect, oxidation state decreases down the group. That is the one thing we should learn from this. Okay, then based on this, we can say this is +3. Here it shows +3 oxidation state. Boron family shows +3 oxidation state by reducing two electrons, ns2. If you reduce two electrons, +1 oxidation state. So in this, boron will exist +1 oxidation or +3 oxidation state. In that, upper higher elements will be stable in the higher oxidation state, lower elements will be stable in the lower oxidation state. So thallium is preferred +1 oxidation state. So thallium, indium, thallium will be stable in +1 oxidation state, whereas boron, aluminium will be stable in +3 oxidation state. Those will be asking us the question, which is stable in which condition. Understood? In this way, if we are for carbon, it is 2 and 4, isn't it? 4 electrons, outermost electron will be 4. So if ns2, if we reduce 2 electrons, that is +2 and +4 oxidation state. Here carbon and silicon will be stable in the +4 oxidation state. Below that, germanium, strontium, lead will be stable in +2 oxidation state. Understood? Lead +2 is more stable than the strontium and germanium. In these type of questions will be asked. In that way, here nitrogen group, this is nitrogen. Nitrogen group, this is 5 electrons in the outermost. If we reduce 2 electrons, +3 and +5 oxidation state. Here these two elements stable in the +5 oxidation state. These three will be stable in +3 oxidation state. That is, higher elements stable in the higher oxidation state, lower elements stable in the lower oxidation state. Okay, in that same way here also 6 in the sense 2 plus 4. Okay, it may be my reduction of 2 electrons, 2 plus 4. So oxygen and sulfur +4 oxidation is stable, the rest of that +2 oxidation is stable. In that type of questions will be asked in this. Okay, next one, which is the best oxidizing agent, whether strontium 4 plus or lead 4 plus? If we are comparing this strontium and lead, here it is strontium and lead, which is more stable? Here lead 4 plus reduces to lead 2 plus according to order, that is 14th group elements, silicon, germanium, strontium, lead. Lead is the last element. Lower elements are more stable in the lower oxidation state. And if it is compare these two, it is the lowest element, strontium and lead. Lead is the lowest element. So lead is more stable than the strontium. In higher oxidation state, strontium is stable. When strontium, how to prove that strontium 4 plus converts to strontium 2 plus becomes less stable and that is lead 4 plus reduces to lead 2 plus is more stable. So lead 2 plus is the reducing agent. Then as it moves down the group, it differs in physical properties such as atomic radius, ionic radius, ionization energy. Chemical properties such as ionization energy, electronegativity. For non-metals, it have high ionization energy. For metals, it will be having low ionization energy. In non-metals, high electronegativity. Metals, low electronegativity. That means, what is that ionization energy? Ionization energy, energy required to remove an electron from the outermost orbital. That is ionization energy. That is electronegativity, capacity to attract a pair of electron towards it. That is electronegativity. We should know the terms so that we can able to answer. Then metals readily lose electron forming cations. Metals tendency. What are metals? Metals readily lose electrons forming cations. Okay, for this metal, that is sodium is the metal, its atomic number is 11. So it readily outermost electron will be 1 and readily loses an electron, becomes 10. And chlorine readily accepts an electron and forms sodium chloride. In this bond between metal and non-metal, this is ionic bond or electrostatic force of attraction bond between metal and non-metal. When we say bond between metal and non-metal, that should be ionic bond. Otherwise, we can say electrostatic force of attraction. That means electrostatic force between two oppositely charged, that is positive and negative charge, okay, strongly attracted to each other, forms sodium chloride. Bond between two non-metals will be covalent bonds. We should remember these for generally. Also, otherwise we cannot able to answer such certain MCQ answers. Okay, then here oxides of non-metals are neutral in nature. How to identify oxide? When it reacts with water, it forms acid, nitrous acid and nitric acid. And metal oxides will form metal hydroxides. Metal oxides, non-metals forms neutral in acidic or neutral in nature. And here it metal will form metal hydroxides with water. Okay. Then P block elements, it is the first elements, primary elements of every group. No, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and helium we should consider, not neon. Here these will not have, these are all smaller in size. When the down the group, the atomic sizes increases. Now introduction of atomic orbit, atomic sizes increases down the group. And so quite naturally, these are all the first element and these are all having the smaller size compared to other metals, and it will not be having, this will have only s orbital, no, that is p orbital, not a d orbital. Absence of d orbital, it will not be forming only four bond. Maximum will be four bonds is possible. Other than that, it is not possible to this. And if carbon and nitrogen shows multiple bonds, catenation, okay, multiple bonds also it is forming. These are all the unique properties of the first elements, anomalous properties of the first element of the in the periodic table, especially in the what is that P block elements. Understood what are all the first one, it will be reduce more electronegativity. As it is closer to the nucleus, it will have more electronegativity and absence of d orbital. It will not be forming it will not be for only forming only tetrahedral structures. As nitrogen and carbon will form multiple bonds, and these multiple bonds involves sidewise overlapping or pi bonding of p orbitals. Understood? These are all the smallest atomic radius in their respective families, shows anomalous properties. Maximum covalence, that means maximum covalence 8, each will be having 2 electrons, so a maximum covalency of these primary elements is 8. Okay, so these are all the restrictions to this. This is the anomalous property of the first elements of p block elements. Then based on the electronic configuration, nitrogen has 7 electrons, 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Here it is forming first one is the sigma bond. First one is the sigma bond, head overlap. Okay. The next one is axial lateral overlap or axial overlap. So no lateral overlap in phosphorus, hence it is the bigger size. But as it is the smallest, we have said about the first element of vanilla of all the groups. So it is not possible to the phosphorus as it is the bigger in size. Okay, and it has d orbital. It will be forming. If it is sigma, that is d pi p pi bond, it will be forming p pi bonds, but it is not false. As it forms p pi, it is in smaller size. We can say when the parapets of two neighboring houses, we can jump easily to other houses without using staircase. But here, as it is a bigger element and it has d orbital, it is not possible to jump over this. If it is too much gap between the parapets, it is not possible to jump over this. We should use staircase. But in case of nitrogen, the parapets of neighboring house will be closer to each other. They can move to their houses without small, youngest one can move through this. Okay, walk through this without using staircase, isn't it? So these are all the differences between the primary elements of all the groups. Okay, so those shows anomalous property, and the rest of that shows this hybridization. It is SS hybridization, SP hybridization, P pi D pi hybridization, in that way. Okay, then here in phosphorus, oxychloride is the example of this. In this oxygen, that is linked with this p orbital of this phosphorus and a d orbital, one electron with the p orbital and one electron with the d orbital. So it shows d pi orbital, p pi d pi orbital formation, hybridization. Okay, so these are all the differences between the first element and the other elements. Then so period 3 element, below this, these are all belongs to period 3 elements. After the period 3 elements, they can achieve expanded octet because of the d orbitals. They can show achieve expanded octet and have unused d orbital. They can have more than 8 electrons. Okay, they can have more than 8 electrons. They will cannot no need not to satisfy the octet rule. That also the exceptions are there. Then we will see the rest. Actually, we have to, these are all the introduction to the boron family. Then in the next video, we will see about the boron family. Till then, bye.